Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss one of the anti-diabetic agent, linagliptin. Linagliptin is one of the drug which can be identified by its suffix gliptin. Gliptins are anti-diabetic agents which are classified as DPP4 inhibitors, dipeptidyl peptidase 4 inhibitors. Linagliptin can control the glucose levels by increasing the insulin secretion. That's why this drug can be indicated in the patients along with proper diet and exercise to treat the type 2 diabetes mellitus. This linagliptin is available as a tablet form which can be taken either with food or without food. And this drug can also be combined with other anti-diabetic agents to produce efficient control on the blood glucose levels. But the glucose levels can also be elevated in type 1 diabetes mellitus. In such patients with elevated levels of glucose, systemic complications may be increased, leading to ketoacidosis, the elevated levels of keto acids. In such conditions, linagliptin should not be used. So this drug is only indicated in the treatment of type 2 diabetes mellitus. One of the key action of this drug is to inhibit the activity of DPP4 enzyme. This is one of the cleavage enzyme which is responsible for breakdown of two important incretins, GLP-1, glucagon-like peptide 1, and GIP, glucose-dependent insulinotropic polypeptide. These two mediators are responsible for increasing the insulin secretion from the beta cells of the pancreas. Both GLP-1 and GIP are metabolized by DPP4 enzyme, which limits their activity. In this context, linagliptin acts as DPP4 inhibitor, thereby it can increase the actions of incretins, leading to increased secretion of insulin. So today in this video, let us see what are the important precautions, side effects, and doses of linagliptin, and how this drug acts. All these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see how this drug acts. On the beta cells of the pancreas, different types of receptors and ion channels are expressed. One of the receptors are GLP-1 receptors. These are the receptors for GLP-1 glucagon-like peptide 1. These are G protein coupled receptors coupled with alpha beta gamma subunits. Another incretin receptors are the GIP receptors. These are the receptors for glucose dependent insulinotropic polypeptide GIP. Again, these are G protein coupled receptors coupled with alpha beta gamma subunits. Now these receptors can be activated by corresponding incretins. GLP-1 is one of the incretin and GIP is the another incretin. When GLP-1 binds to GLP-1 receptors, they are activated, resulting in the stimulation of adenylyl cyclase system. This adenylyl cyclase can convert the ATP into one of the important secondary messenger, cyclic AMP. Similarly, GIP can activate the GIP receptors, which again leads to the activation of cyclic AMP. So both of the incretins can increase the cyclic AMP levels within the beta cells. This cyclic AMP then activates one group of enzymes, protein kinase A. These are the phosphorylating enzymes which can control various cellular activities by controlling the different types of ion channels. The protein kinase A can control one of the ion channel, ATP sensitive potassium channel. Similarly, it can control the calcium channels on the beta cells as well as the sodium channels. Now, because of increased levels of protein kinase A, sodium can more enter into the membrane. At the same time, potassium cannot go outside, resulting in the increased depolarization, which stimulates the entry of calcium into the cell, leading to more depolarization. Thereby, insulin is going to be secreted out of the beta cells. In this way, incretins can increase the release of insulin from the beta cells, as well as they can also reduce the secretion of glucagon from alpha cells. But the action of these incretins like GLP-1 and GIP is controlled by one of the metabolic enzyme DPP4, dipeptidyl peptidase 4. This enzyme is responsible for cleavage of incretins so that their activity is going to be reduced. Now, linagliptin is one of the drug which can selectively bind to the DPP4 enzyme, thereby it inhibits the activity of this enzyme. When this enzyme is inhibited, the levels of GLP-1 as well as GIP are increased, which enhance the binding of these incretins with corresponding receptors. leading to increased secretion of insulin. In this way, linagliptin can increase the insulin secretion as well as it can reduce the glucagon secretion, by which it can reduce the blood glucose levels. Now, let us the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of linagliptin is that this drug can produce hypoglycemia. Since this drug increases the insulin secretion, which reduces the blood glucose levels, so linagliptin can produce hypoglycemia as one of the important side effects, which should be carefully monitored. This is more important when this linagliptin is combined with insulin secretagogues. For instance, sulfonylureas are one category of drugs which can increase the insulin secretion. These sulfonylureas can directly act on the beta cells so that they can inhibit the ATP sensitive potassium channels. When these potassium channels are blocked, again beta cells are depolarized, resulting in the secretion of insulin. Since linagliptin and sulfonylureas can increase the insulin secretion, when they are combined, a significant hypoglycemia can be produced. That's why whenever insulin secretagogues like sulfonylureas are to be combined with linagliptin, then the dose of sulfonylurea should be reduced in order to prevent severe hypoglycemia in the patients. Another important precaution is that linagliptin can produce hypersensitive reactions. Even these effects can be observed in only few of the people, but still care should be taken. And if any hypersensitive reactions are developed towards the linagliptin, then use of this drug should not be continued. And any symptoms like urticaria, eczema, skin rashes, angioedema resulting in swelling of lips, tongue, pharynx, if any of these symptoms are observed, immediately the drug should be stopped due to development of fatal hypersensitive reactions. Another important precaution is that linagliptin can act on the pancreas, so it can develop the pancreatitis, the inflammation of the pancreas, as one of the important side effects. This is a common side effect that is observed with DPP-4 inhibitors like linagliptin and other drugs. So in the patient, any symptoms that indicate the development of pancreatitis should be thoroughly checked. So any development of severe abdominal pain or nausea and vomiting may indicate pancreatitis. In such conditions, linagliptin should be carefully used. What are the side effects? The important side effects of linagliptin mainly include nasopharyngitis. It can produce some sore throat and cold-like symptoms. Another important side effect is the hypoglycemia because of increased insulin secretion. Due to this hypoglycemia, linagliptin can produce various other side effects like confusion, excessive sweating, tiredness in the patients, and even it can produce some difficulty in concentrating so that the patient may have confused state. All these effects are because of development of hypoglycemia due to the use of linagliptin. And this is more important when this linagliptin is combined with other antidiabetic agents, which again increase the insulin secretion. Other side effects mainly include the abdominal pain. And in case of severe abdominal pain, any development of pancreatitis should be checked. Similarly, linagliptin can also produce skin rashes because of any hypersensitive reactions. Now, let us the chemical nature of this drug. So, this is the structure of linagliptin. We can see different rings are present in the structure. The central ring is nothing but the purine, which is having the ketone groups at the second and sixth position. So this is purine 2,6-dione. And this ring is attached to a heterocyclic ring system here. This is nothing but the pyrimidine. This is nothing but the piperidine with amino group. So amino piperidine ring is present. And on the other side, it is attached with quinazoline ring. So sitagliptin is a combination of these three rings. How it is given? This drug is available as a tablet and it is available at a strength of 5 mg. The dose of sitagliptin is started at 5 mg once daily to control the blood glucose levels, and sometimes it can be combined with other drugs such as metformin in order to reduce the raised blood glucose levels in the patients with type 2 diabetes mellitus. And this drug can be taken either with food or without food, because food have no significant effect on absorption of linagliptin. So that's all about this drug, linagliptin, which is a DPP-4 inhibitor, dipeptidyl peptidase 4 inhibitor. Because of inhibition of activity of this enzyme, linagliptin can increase the levels of incretins like GLP-1, glucagon-like peptide 1, and GIP, glucose-dependent insulinotropic polypeptide. When these incretins levels are increased, they can act on their corresponding receptors on beta cells of pancreas, which increase the depolarization resulting in the secretion of insulin. So linagliptin indirectly increases the insulin secretion. That's why hypoglycemia is one of the important precautions that should be considered with this drug, which is more important when this drug is combined with other antidiabetic agents that again increase the insulin secretion. For instance, sulfonylureas can increase the insulin secretion when they are given with linagliptin, so the dose of the sulfonylurea should be reduced in order to prevent severe hypoglycemia. Pancreatitis is another important side effect that can be observed with linagliptin, commonly observed with DPP-4 inhibitors. So that's all about this drug, linagliptin. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.